Hey y'all, what's up, what's up? It's your girl here, Ida Marie. Yes, we're going to be talking about an incident that happened earlier. It was about black faces again. We're going to break it down and explain what exactly is wrong. What was wrong with this show or this festival. What I want you guys to start doing is you guys need to have a dictionary with you. I don't feel like people know what racism and prejudice and stereotype mean. They are three different words and they all mean something different. Racism is the harshest word. It's the most hurtful word ever. That's basically, you know, putting a race atop another race. You think your race is better than the other race. You think the other race is dirt to your race. That's racism. You hate that other race, basically. So when I'm talking about these different things, I tend to bring up stereotypes. Stereotype is where you say, you know, all Asian people are book smart. They all know math. They're all good at math. They all look like nerds or something like that. They're all geniuses. Or all Asian people, you know, all Chinese people, they hate black people. That's a stereotype. You put in someone in a category. When you put another race in a category and you really don't know what's going on, that's stereotype. Prejudice, I'm gonna let y'all look that one up for yourself, because I'm kind of cutting short on time here in the studio, but y'all need to look up these definitions. I'm not gonna look it up. I was gonna break it up and look it up for you guys. I'm not doing that. You guys are grown adults. If you can come on YouTube and look at my video, you guys need to look up stereotype, prejudice, and what else? Stereotype, prejudice, and racism. Y'all need to know those definitions because a lot of people don't know what those definitions mean. And you can't open your mouth and comment if you don't know what those words mean. Okay? So let's get into the reaction video, all right?
Having a number of blackface incidents popping up all over Asia. And recently, it happened again on a popular Chinese TV show, which apparently watched by over 800 million Chinese people. So why does something like this keep happening? Are we missing something? To get some real insight, let's hit the street of Shanghai to see what ordinary Chinese people have to say about this incident.
中国人还播出的春晚吗？春晚在中国是很大的一个节目嘛？啊，对的，是最大的节目了，等于是。既然美国人看，那就是Super Bowl。基本上大部分的老百姓都能够去看这个节目。那你能跟我们描述一下刚刚你看到一些场面是什么？哦，这个讲的是就是中非的一个，可能一个铁不项目还是什么，然后可能其中的一小段。中国人和非洲人的一个友谊吧，然后呢，就是非洲的有人用其他非常丰满，然后穿着的非常就是颜色非常各异，然后又跟我们就是新年非常有那个联系。刚刚看到那个视频当中，其实端的那个水果出来的那个女士，你知道是哪里人吗？
好像是看的时候是非洲的。
其实刚刚那个端水果出来的那位女士其实是中国人。
是吗？他其实把这个亚洲人呢涂成了非洲人，把脸涂成了黑色，然后还做了一个假的大的屁股。那你知道这样子的事实中，你是怎么想的？
化妆师可以涨工资。差一点，因为我想我们应该可以找到很合适的非洲人来演吗？还是经费不够吗？难道没有办法请到一个？
首先，第一个是很滑稽，第二个是觉得中非文化的一种融合吧。
我觉得也没有非说要歧视有色人种或者。
我觉得没什么呀，就是这个是在模仿。 非洲人的一个形体特征吧。
The older ones don't see anything wrong with it. They think it's cool.
很多非洲人在中国看到都比较苗条，但也有人说他屁股比较翘，但没有这么翘，因为他这个有点过了，就可能达到一个喜剧效果。
那你觉得这个属于是种族歧视吗？
我觉得不是，可能他就是中国人传统概念里面对非洲人的印象，对某一个国家或者说一个文化的一个固定的观念吧。就像可能国外的人会认为我们中国人可能就是矮矮小小胖胖的那种。
那你们，我想告诉你们是，其实很多外国的人在看了这个视频了之后，他们就觉得有点种族歧视。
Not racist.
为什么呀？为什么呀？
那中国人胖的也有啊。其实我觉得看了还只有可爱可亲了，他们太敏感，我觉得还是蛮可爱的。
然后我们其实对外国他们在就是描述我们中国文化的时候，也有会有一些不到位的地方。本身的话也是大家在这种不断的交流当中去朋友，然后去尊敬的。然后如果说真的给外国有人带来这样子，就是心里还有些不适的话，可能对我们以后做节目的时候也会有所改进。
如果是在国外的话，很多外国人，哎，他把自己白人，他把自己人涂成黄色，然后弄个小眼睛，然后去逗乐大家。你如果看到这个东西，你会开心吗？
也没什么不开心，就是中国人，中国就是这个样子。
That wouldn't upset her if somebody was dressed up as a Chinese person.
Okay. 有些场合他是，就是故意有这种影射的话，也可能会生气。但是如果是出于一些就是引别人一笑的这种场合，我觉得还可以，是可以接受。
那我会不高兴。我认为他做的有是偏颇，
但是如果他们觉得我们只是为了娱乐呀，
所以说，春晚还是再多多考虑一下。
Yeah, sure,
没有
considering.
我也不开心，
但是基本上能看出来他们这个是故意搞丑，你还是纯粹是搞娱乐性为了那个。好像如果再是像这春晚这么个隆重、这么个慎重的地方，也不可能要去丑化他们。我觉得没这个必要，好像。
哦，就这个没想到，可能你这样讲到以后就觉得哦，
是
有点这样的问题。
那
被你提醒以后，我觉得可能不大。但是我觉得从我中国人的角度，我可能说这个的问题是没想到，就别的人的想法。
你周围有什么黑人朋友或者黑人同学啊之类的吗？
我们上大学的时候，感觉对他们的印象就是很香很香。整层就是上课的时候，可能会觉得只要他们有在教室，整层楼都是香的。
Bother me or African American? That don't bother me. Black American, African American.
其实黑人没有整体来说，
with African.
因为我住的小区里面也有黑人。整体来说是比较友好的。对。
那他们的形象和春晚出现的一些形象一样吗？
不一样，不一样。生活中真的其实很少这样那样的。
对的。
虽然小区里有黑人，然后他那个夸张一些。
Thank you. I think it went over a little overboard.
那你接触到那些曾经接触到一些黑人什么样的形象呢？亲身经历。
I just think it's negative. I don't think it's racist.
就是
I just think it's negative.
比较爱占小便宜。
负面的话呢，就比较可能是贫穷。
那你觉得很多时候中国人得到了这些负面的这种印象是从何而来的呢？
是因为一种个别的案例会影响到整个国内的，会影响它的影响。
一方面是可能是经济水平决定的，再一个的话可能跟。就是我们从小到大接触到的这些媒体的宣传也有一定的关系，可能如果主流的就是官方宣传上都是介绍到他们一些就是被歧视的一方或者是不平等的东西，大众接受到的这些会影响我们的判断。
就是说如果美国的电影啊或他们的描述关于美国的就是这个黑人的那种歧视的问题，
那对于中国的一些媒体上有没有一些类似的一些影响？
我觉得比较少，可能都是描述别人怎么种族歧视别人。
这个黑人角色设定会把他们设定那些小偷啊，会设定一些这个一些罪犯，生活在底层的一些哎，就说是垃圾之类的。哎，
那在未来有没有可能啊？中国对于这非洲的一些负面的一些形象啊，或者是会更多的消失？
那
是
肯定的，因为
没有人
不
了解
这些问题，都会从随着交流来。
And that's why they're gonna think about black people.
这样的耗时，我觉得差不多。还得需要三五十年或者是上百年的时间，因为这种民族之间的融合还是非常慢，因为从历史上来讲，你说那中国融合了这么多民族，现在才形成一种这种共荣的这种局面，我觉得应该不会说对于黑人有多么大的歧视，整个中国我觉得还是比较有信心，关键就是说，
要有这个机会组织一个桥梁，就是当你了解对方越多的时候，那你的心态就会发生改变，对他的认识才更全面。就是因为我们年轻一代就接触新事物，接受新事物的能力会比较强，所以对于这种新鲜的这些外来的文化，还是以一种比较客观的眼光来对待。
How long have you been living in China, right, and what motivated you to come here?
So I've been in China, I think, around 4.5 years or a little more than that. And I was motivated to come here because I actually studied Chinese in university.
What do you make of the recent incident of blackface on the CCTV Lunar New Year's show?
So I was actually watching that show. At first, when I first saw it, I thought it was an African woman who had a fake butt and stuff, which I thought was weird, but I was like, well, it's China. And which is what, that's a lot of people's response when they see stuff like this.
A lot of people thought
that
was a black woman.
And then when I kind of looked at it, I was like, wait, but there's so many Africans in China who speak Chinese. Like, I didn't understand why. It's like, I almost want like someone to explain why it happened. Like, even if they couldn't find an elderly
African
woman who spoke Chinese, they could have made up a black person to look old. Like, they had so many options. This is from a black American perspective. This is not from African perspective. I don't know what Africans think about that skit. They might be angry, they might not. Because the thing is, blackface is historically in the U.S. has negative origins because basically white people would paint their face black. It was very obvious that they were in blackface. They wouldn't try to make themselves actually look like an African American. And they would do stereotypical things, kind of degrading. It was just a way to dehumanize black people, make them more like a character, a cartoonist.
Where did he get that idea from?
Have you encountered, like, examples?
That's just my question. Where did he get that idea from? Because that it has to be from America.
I like to call it colorism, in terms of what I've experienced personally myself, which is essentially Chinese people giving me compliments and saying, oh, you're black, but you're not dark. Or they'll make fun of somebody else and go, oh, but he's so dark. And then I'll say, well, what's wrong with that? And I feel part of it is lack of exposure to different types
That's
of
what
black
it
people.
Is.
What about any of your friends, for example?
They'll see much more racism than I do, where sometimes I think it doesn't exist, and then sometimes I do see where they might be where it might be true. For example, sitting on a subway, some people have said that people won't sit next to them, or they'll, like, get up. Move away from them. One friend told me that when she was working at Disney, someone called her the Chinese word for the N-word. So yeah, it's definitely going to be different for different people. In general,
I think it's different.
I haven't had too much of a problem. The issue is when you can understand Chinese, I think it makes it a little different. Because, for example, I used to teach at a school like 3 years ago. And you could hear, like, I remember hearing one of the parents saying, thank goodness I have the white teacher, not the black teacher.
What?
And the funny thing is that her teacher was actually a non-native speaker from Europe, who he could speak good English, but he had a, you know, very thick accent. He didn't have, like, a native American accent that Chinese people associate with good quality English when they're having their kids learn English. I applied for one job where they do recruiting. And they told me, sometimes we get schools who only want white people. They said, are you comfortable with that?
What?
I said yes at the time, honestly, but I wasn't comfortable, but I just didn't want to make it awkward. Now they have something called Obama Black, which is, it's basically, as long as you're the color of Obama,
you accept it.
That
I've heard
okay.
of that.
If you're darker than Obama, it's not okay, because at least at this point, because Obama's the president of the United States, people will, they can accept people that color as being American, but not if you're darker than that, then you're African. So it's, the perception changed a little bit with Obama, but it did make things like,
it didn't
away,
change anything.
Basically, but you will see ads that say white
I think
only.
People who are my complexion
and
darker
that I joke with my
is still hard
that
for
like,
us.
Do you have white skin? You can come work at, it was basically a job where you didn't have to do anything. You just like sat at the reception and you just say hi to people and you get 16,000 RMB a month to do that as long as you're white.
So, how do you process these experiences? Is it any different?
Oh, yeah, it's much different. Actually, a lot of black people you'll talk to say they prefer the racism in China over back in the States. And that's just because some people perceive the racism here or the prejudice here. I don't really like to call it racism, but I don't want to get into that. They perceive it to be differently because here they see it more as ignorance,
Whereas in the States, it's more like hate. Like, people actually hate you and, like, want to kill you or threaten you violently. But in China, it's more like, it's just different. It doesn't seem like they hate you. Like, especially when I speak Chinese, I can go almost anywhere and talk to people. At least in the places I've been so far, and people kind of accept me, I guess. I don't know how else to explain that, but they won't be like, oh, get out of my store. They won't follow me around in the store and see if I'm trying to steal something. They won't, like, I don't know, be rude to me. Now, that's not the case for all black people. Again, I'm the Obama black, I guess.
Exactly.
That
you gotta keep that in mind.
So when you have kind of darker skinned black people, their experiences are much, much different than mine.
How have your experiences affected the way you perceive Chinese people?
Even despite the negative, most of them have been mostly positive, and especially knowing the culture, knowing the language, it kind of showed to me, if you kind of accept their culture and their language and kind of, not necessarily integrate, but like accept it and see them as people, they will kind of show you the same respect. Chinese people I've talked to have been very receptive. They're very likely to engage in dialogue and to talk about it, and they'll usually say, oh, I never thought of that, and you know, you really changed the way I see things. So open dialogue, changing stereotypes in TVs and movies in particular, I'm going to keep saying that only because every time Chinese people will talk to me about Americans or whatever people, they'll say
they saw it
on
television. That's what they do.
So,
yeah.
All of that. And I think maybe if, you know, just more black, there's a lot of Africans now in China who are here to study, and they know Chinese. So also the more they interact with black people who speak Chinese, I think that will also help us well.
All right, so let me give you my viewpoint out of it real quick, like, before I, because I need to go cutting into time here. But I'm going to wrap it up for you guys. Okay. The problem is, like what they've been stating, is people see things on television and they kind of, you know, go off on that, and they feel that that's how a black person act. I actually talked about Wendy from Red Velvet. Someone brought this to my attention about how she act like a black girl and then she act like a white girl. I'm not sure why in Asia they want to act like a different race all the time. That's their way of entertainment. That's what I tell people, because they feel that's their way of understanding a race. It's, a lot of people call it racism. It's not racism. It's like she said, it's ignorance. It's because they don't know anything and they don't want to learn anything. So this is whatever they see, that's what they go off of. It's stereotyping. It falls underneath stereotype. That's the word that I'm going to pick. I think it falls underneath stereotype, because you're still putting the whole race in a category and you're not learning to know who they truly are. And some of the Chinese had, they really did, you know, came through for black people. They really did talk really well about the Africans. I mean, African Americans are Africans. And what I mean by that is, when I say Africans and African Americans, some Africans, and I try to tell even white people this, and they looked at me like I was stupid. I said, Africans like to be called Africans. They don't like being called black. They're not born and raised in America. They were from Africa, okay? That's the difference. And I've said this over and over and over, and people think that is stupid. But if you don't understand that, then I don't know what to say for you. No, because a lot of people don't know this. They don't understand it. Please research it and look it up. I might put something down in the description of Asian Boss, of this whole video, if you want to see it again. And also, I'm going to put in description about black faces, because you guys need to know where that came from. Didn't came from a good place, came from a negative place. And you guys need to know the definition of stereotype, prejudice, and racism as well, okay? So I'm going to go ahead and put this together and upload this to you guys, alright? Peace out.